All right, everybody, we are all packed up, gonna hit the road. We're gonna make it to Trinidad, Colorado today, and then we'll be driving to our unknown destination that we will not be sharing with y'all tomorrow. So by tomorrow afternoon, 5 o'clock, we'll probably have a bull elk in the truck. No, I'm just kidding. We'll be sucking air tomorrow afternoon, trying to get acclimated and try to find out where all the pressure's coming from. And then probably see Monday morning, we'll probably start hitting the trails and getting after some elk. So we're gonna hit the road. We'll probably bring some entertaining footage from the road along the way, but y'all stay tuned. We're gonna be hunting for 8 or 9, 10 days, so it's sure to be entertaining. Stay tuned. Just on the road. We got
you're an elk. You're an animal. You have emotions.
A little while left.
Listen to him when he's calling. You're gonna see. He's
about 5 hours till we get out of Texas.
But he's mixing it.
God bless him.
Passing the time with some.
And so when he's communicating with you, it
podcasts.
Makes it that much easier because now you can see by his emotional sound.
Good stuff.
Where he's at.
Good morning, everybody. We're back on the road this morning. We stopped in Trinidad last night to. to get a little sleep and start to acclimate to the climate. Trinidad's at about 6,000 feet, so we're starting to just get used to the elevation. We've got about 6 hour drive to where we're hunting today. We're gonna spend the rest of the day starting to get acclimated. Like I said, we're not gonna push into it too hard and get elevation sickness. So we're headed that way. It is a beautiful, clear morning. The sunrise in the Sangre de Cristos is just beautiful, so we're gonna keep to it today. Hopefully this afternoon me and Reed are starting to get acclimated to the elevation, and tomorrow we can hit the hunt. So y'all stay tuned.
So a nice little trick, this is tips with Reed, nice little trick to get acclimated faster is you have to breathe in and out really fast. Like do you want to stretch, especially after a car, and then just right after that stretch, just go straight into some heavy. And what that does, it helps expand your lungs to help the blood flow and to help you breathe better.
Thanks, Reed.
You're welcome.
Well, we made it. We are currently at, 10,500, 11,000 feet?
Yeah.
We drove all the way up and there was camps the whole way up, and we ran into a couple people, said they weren't seeing any elk sign. Seen a lot of mule deer, but no elk sign. So we came to the end where there's this lake up here at the top, and there was only a couple people up here, and the only hunters that we talked to said they actually saw elk today. So that's a good report. So we're about to run a ridge here, make about a 3 mile loop this afternoon, maybe a little less, and see what we can find. So y'all stay tuned. We've got camp set up here. Reed, show them a little bit of what we got around camp here. Got a little fire pit. Got our tent set up. Brooks of Babylon down there. So we got a nice little setup. It's a little warm. It's in the upper 70s probably, but it feels nice. We're gonna go out here and walk until our lungs give out. Y'all stay tuned. Well, we quickly got introduced to what blowdown is. It took us 30 minutes to cover a quarter of a mile, but we've got ourselves out into this clearing here. We can do a little glassing. We're going to try and figure out what this country like this over here looks like. So far, it's not looked like anybody is hunting in this area. I haven't heard any bugles over here yet. Haven't seen any boot tracks. So just by going through a little blowdown, I think we may have put some of the pressure behind us. Now we just need the elk to be here. So we saw one old dropping and maybe a couple tracks. There's cattle in the area, so we don't know how far the cattle will go. We think they're gonna stay more in the lower pastures, but we'll find out. But we're gonna sit here for a minute, take a break, try to cover some ground, maybe throw some bugles out, and see if anything responds.
All right. Well, good morning, everybody. Our plan this morning was to hike back into a different basin, but we woke up feeling slightly weak after last night. If you notice, we didn't give you a post-hunt interview last night. It's because we hiked up this death ridge and just barely made it back to camp. So it's a bad choice. So what we're doing now is we're just walking, or not really, but we're driving these roads, scouting for hunters. And if we get to an area where there hadn't been a truck for a mile or so, get out and call. But we're gonna spend the morning just driving around, looking to see where all the pressure's at, do a little bit more scouting, and then hit the field this afternoon. So let's see if anything answers.
I think so too.
I wish we were hunting mule deer. There's a bigger one behind it. Look at that, behind it. Look, see it to the left?
Yeah.
Holy.
One right's looking at you.
Holy crap. Officially seen everything but elk.
Well, as you can see, we are not in the backcountry. We're in a hotel. That unit was just devoid of elk. We talked to probably 15 other hunters. No bugles, no sightings, nothing. Talked to one guy who was a local, been hunting there for a while. He said that he was gonna be not coming back to that unit this season. So we didn't have any confidence in it, so we decided we're gonna back out of there. Because if you don't have confidence, you won't hunt hard. So we drove to a town, came to a McDonald's, got on the computer, researched some areas. Found a new area, it's supposed to have a lot of hunting pressure, but the success rate is still pretty high. So we're gonna go try that unit out. I think it's probably around 15% success rate, but it's probably the most heavily hunted unit in Colorado. But it's a lot easier terrain, and it's more glassable terrain. I feel like we'll be able to maybe glass some elk. So we're gonna try that out for a few days, see how that works. So we're gonna be sleeping like kings tonight, and then next few days hitting it up back in the backcountry. So y'all keep watching. I promise we'll try to get some elk footage here soon.
Well, we're about to hit the road. It's a new day, new morning, new unit, whole new type of terrain. So we're gonna get to it.
No, I'm done. I'm out.
Take two. We made it to the new area. It seems like there's some areas that are a little less treacherous. There's a little bit more hunting pressure here, but according to our quick internet research last night, there's a really high population of elk here. So if you can get past the hunters, you can find elk. It's hot, so we're gonna try to focus on water holes. that's the plan. So this afternoon we're going to hike back into some water holes that we've seen on the map, see if there's any good sign, and then if there's not, hike our way back out and try something different tomorrow. So we'll see y'all on the trail.
We found elk tracks. They seem older, but it's our first elk tracks. So that's good. They're all spread out in the mud here. There's a good one there. Elk tracks. All right.
Okay, everybody, so a big change of plans. We got burnt up being in the mountains, got our butts handed to us. So I started doing some research, and I found a certain area that's in a certain place that is not in the mountains that has elk. It's wide open, spot and stalk country with water holes. It's pretty flat. It's big, vast country, no vehicles allowed, and we've already spotted some elk. I think, what did we see, three bulls?
Yeah.
Four bulls, maybe? We've already spotted like four bulls and a herd of cows. They were probably 2 miles away. We've only got it about an hour and a half of daylight left, so there's no way we could have made it and stalked on them on time. We're just driving around to the access points until we find elk. And like I said, we've already found some. We're gonna go check a few more access points and then head into town for the night. So y'all stay tuned. Things are starting to pick up a bit. Well, we made it back here to this lake. We biked back in here about 3.5 miles, and we got up on this corral right here behind me where we could see, and haven't seen any elk yet. So we're gonna get back on the bikes, maybe head a mile or two to the north. This is some crazy country. Let me show you what this looks like. So there's a mountain range over there, and we're down in the valley. There's that big lake right over there. It's pretty neat. It's pretty neat. I say there's a big herd of elk that lives out here. We just gotta find them. We've spotted some elk. We just barely got a glimpse of them as they crest over a ridge. We're trying to chase them down on the bikes. Try to get our eyes on him again. Had some other hunters ride up on us. I don't think he's going in the direction of the elk. We're gonna try to make a play on him here real quick. Okay, I've got my eyes on him. We're gonna stay in this low ground. We dropped the bikes. We're gonna start hiking. I think we're maybe 800 yards away from him. We're gonna try to cut him off. Things just got interesting.
do this.
Here you go. He gone. As he got up, he looked like he was gonna run right down that gully.
Wind shifted on us.
Yeah, he got us good.
He got a good whiff on us.
All right, where's that other group?
Well, we got away to within 100 yards of a good 6x6. We had a perfect wind. It was going off this way. And then right when we get here close to him, the wind shifts right towards it. And he was bedded down and he stood up. I tried to go cut him off, but he hauled, but he got a couple hundred yards away real fast. There's still a herd somewhere of about 8 bulls. We gotta try to locate them now and give it another shot. They're gonna bed down here soon, so we gotta find them before they bed down, because then they'll disappear. They're about 400 yards away. Start moving toward them. All right, we've got these elk spotted. They're bedded down, maybe 300 yards away. I'm gonna make a loop to get on the good side of the wind and try to sneak up on them. So, here we go. Okay, I'm about 50 to 70 yards away from these bulls now. I've got a good wind. I'm gonna start going pretty slow now, about 2 to 3 yards at a time. We'll see what happens. Well, I got up to them without about 30 yards of those bulls. Just made some bad mistakes. I should have drew a lot quicker than I did. And I should have taken more ranges of things behind where the bulls were. When they stood up, he was behind a bush. I couldn't get a shot. And then he bounded off, and I thought he bounded off maybe 20, 30 yards, but I wasn't sure. But that was really cool. I only thought there was like 4 or 5 bulls there. It turns out there was like 9 there. And I got really close to him. I took my boots off and got real close, and then I just should have drew a lot quicker than I did, and I maybe could have gotten a shot off, but lessons learned, we're gonna go find another one. So we got sand in my camera, and the lens won't open and shut anymore. So I'm gonna be finishing out on the GoPros and my cell phone. We took it a little easy this afternoon, because there's been, as you can see, there's been quite a few storms rolling around. So we took a little easy this afternoon. Tomorrow it's supposed to be a little cool front blowing in, so we're gonna be prepared to stay out in the field all day tomorrow and get it done. This morning was eventful. Like I say, I got up on that group of bulls, and I just didn't execute the stalk. Well, I executed the stalk. I didn't execute the kill at the end. I should have drew a lot sooner than I did, and by the time that I was drawing, I didn't know their range anymore. I think they were 60, but they could have been 80. They could have been 40. It's so wide and vast out there. It's hard to range. So that was just rookie spot and stalk mistakes. But anyways, I have some friends that live in this town. We're actually gonna go watch a football game tonight. So y'all stay tuned. Tomorrow ought to be an eventful day of hunting. on today's segment with Tips and Tricks with Reed.
Check this.
Thanks, Reed.